Sure.
Running.
Me too. But by the way, I love your new jacket.
Thanks, it's juicy.
So cute. Anyway, I heard we had a new head teacher and she's so
annoying. I know, she made up so many
notes. I know,
it's not that many notes.
I'm so sorry.
Get away from me.
It's ruined.
Grandpa was a quiet man. He taught his lessons well.
He showed me ways to understand the stories I still tell.
The first time I lost a game, he told me what to do.
So now you're my son. In Grandpa's name, I'll say the same to you.
Hold your head up proudly. Wipe that tear off your eye.
You can still be a winner, but winners never cry.
You just reap the place where winners all begin.
You have to know the taste of loss to savour any win.
If you want to see a rainbow, you'll have to take the rain.
If you want to be successful, you have to take the strain.
If you want to be a winner, hold your head up high.
You have to know how to lose because winners never cry.
You could win almost any game with jump and shout for joy.
That's a part of life shared by every growing boy.
But here's a thought for little guys who join the ranks of men.
The winner is the loser who can suck it up and try it again.
If we didn't have birthdays, you wouldn't be you.
If you'd never been born, well, what would you do?
If you've never been born, then what would you be?
You might be a fish or a toad in the tree.
You might be a doorknob or three baked potatoes.
You might be a bag full of green hard tomatoes.
Or worse than that,
why, you might be a wasm.
A wasm has no fun at all.
No, he doesn't.
A wasm, he isn't, he just isn't present.
You are you. Now, isn't that pleasant?
It's got slime. It looks hungry. And where is dinner?
Ron.
Will you forget me in 1 minute?
No.
Will you forget me in 1 day?
No.
Will you forget me in 1 week?
No.
Will you forget me for 1 month?
No.
Will you forget me in a year?
No.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
You forgot me.
Can I go to the toilet?
Can I go to the toilet, please?
Can I go to the toilet?
Can I go to the toilet?
Can I go to the toilet, please?
Why do you need to take your bag with you?
That's personal.
Copy that. Dun, 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 dun.
What do you think you're doing out here?
My favourite thing about myself is probably my creativity of dance and how I try hard to reach up for my goals.
What's your favourite thing about yourself?
I like that I'm kind and I'm a good friend.
That I make sure everyone in the world feels equal, class clown quite a bit.
My favourite thing about myself is that I'm funny, kind and cool.
That I'm courageous and speak my own opinion.
I like that I am kind and I'm a good friend.
What is your favourite thing about yourself?
I like that I have a lot of friends, and I like that I like acting and dancing.
I like that I play football and enjoy the great game.
I have quite a good sense of humour, and I'm quite energetic, and I'm quite kind as well.
My favourite thing about myself would probably be that I have multiple qualities to my personality, that I can be fun, energetic, but I can be overprotective at times of the people, like my friends, my family.
I like my personality. I think I have a great personality, to be honest, so yeah.
What would you tell someone coming to the UK?
I would tell them where they are.
I tell them that the food is very delicious and they're very kind people.
What would you tell someone coming to the UK?
To eat fish and chips and probably go to Peaky Way.
Welcome to the UK, where so many kind people live.
What would you tell someone coming to the UK?
The Queen is a great queen.
I tell them it's that lovely place and everyone's proud of who they are.
I would say, do you want me to show you around, or the UK's a wonderful place?
It's cold. You need to live somewhere where it's hot, otherwise you will freeze to death.
The weather is a bit on and off. People are mostly nice. Many stuff to do, good schools and places to eat. Many famous people from here, like Ant and Dec. Nice shops and places to live as well.
What would you tell someone coming to the UK?
To bring a coat. I tell them that the food is very delicious and they're very kind people.
What do you think the future's like?
No school, and that everyone will have money, a job, food and water.
I think it will be quite hard to live because of global warming. I think it will get quite a bit warmer.
Everyone will be equal and there will be no discrimination.
I think there's going to be a lot of robots, and not that many people are going to read than they do nowadays. Probably like 8% or something like that, yeah.
I think that the future will be that humans start to realise maybe how bad climate change is, and the countries around the world and their leaders work together to save like the world from climate change.
I think that there's no problems like discrimination, poachers, pickpocketers.
Hopefully world problems are going to pass and there's going to be cool stuff like robots.
Well, I want it to be like have flying cars and like robot servants and like no illnesses, but more realistically it will be like lots of things in the supermarket and stuff will be like way more expensive.
I think flying cars is a bit absurd and a bit out there.
I think in the future there will be no discrimination and everyone can be who they want to be.
The future is a mystery. You never know, so you have to be excited for what opportunities life throws at you.
Why does the banana cross the road?
I don't know.
Because it was too fast and it slipped.
Do you think we're safe here?
I don't know.
If we don't make it out of here,
we're dead meat.
I know. What was that?
Your imagination playing tricks.
Do you think we'll make it out of here alive?
I don't know. I really don't know.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
I did that.
I did that too.
He did it for you.
Once there was an elephant who tried to use the telephone.
No, I mean an elephant who tried to use the telephone.
Dear me, I'm not certain quite that even now I've got it right.
However it was, he got his trunk entangled in a telephunk.
An elephant who tried to use the telephone.
I fear I better drop the song of elephant and telephone.
I know someone that sounds like an owl.
We lived through times when hate and fear seem stronger. We rise and fall, and light from dying embers. Remembrance is that hope, and love lasts longer.
And love is love is love is love.
Is love is love is love is love.
Cannot be killed or swept aside.
What do you call a ladybug with no spots?
I don't know.
A spotless.
The people upstairs always practice ballet.
Their living room is a bowling alley.
Their bedroom is filled with conducted tours.
Their radio is louder than yours.
They celebrate weekends all the week.
When they take a shower, your ceilings leak.
They try to get their parties to mix
while supplying their guests with pogo sticks.
And when their fun at last abates,
they go to the bathroom on roller skates.
I like the people upstairs more.
If they only lived on another floor.
It was a bright day in March and all the clocks were ticking.
The rat race we lived would now face a kicking.
We found kindness in people we had never seen before.
The corridors were empty, the classrooms were bare.
The tension was high and the teachers were stressed.
This time gave the world some hope and some rest.
We missed all the hugs, but they got even tighter.
We all got through it, we are all a fighter.
Don't give up hope, love is in sight.
If we all stick together, we will win this fight.
Thank you.
Look what I got.
Oh, that's nice. Where's it from?
A local boutique shop called Le Bedron de Grasse.
Very exclusive.
Jane.
Grace is going to go crazy if you keep stealing her stuff without asking again.
It's fine. I'm advanced borrowing. You know, use now, ask later.
Where did you even find this?
Found it in her wardrobe when I was returning the coat I borrowed.
Stole. I swear one day she's going to...
Today, the mini bandit, distinctive for their long braided hair, purple glasses, but super strength, left the bank with over £10,000 just before 5 p.m. this evening.
You don't think?
Crazy day at work.
I can help.
So, thank you. What have you been doing today? Preferably between the hours of 3 and 5.
All right, what is it? This is the last time I'm going to ask you, okay?
If you rob that bank down on the high street, just say,
and give us the car.
Jane, my dad knows a really good lawyer, okay?
That's my piggy bank.
You made it then. We're running out of time.
How many of us are left? Is Chloe still...
I'm sorry. She's one of them now.
What are we going to do?
I've heard there's a place in the hills where all the people who aren't infected are meeting there.
Safety in numbers, right?
Exactly. Then we'll decide what to do.
We're going to die, aren't we?
No, Sam. We're not going to die. We're going to fight.
Children, well, they misbehave, they mess up your house, and they're really mean sometimes. What's your favourite game?
There's loads of different games in the world, so it would be pretty hard to choose. I kind of like most.
I like going to places where I enjoy it, so like parks and like places where you can buy stuff.
Do you want to be an actor when you're older?
No.
Yeah.
Why do you not want to be an actor when you're older?
I don't want to be famous.
I want to be an actress because when I'm older I want to be famous on stage.
What's your favourite food?
If you had one thing you could buy in the whole world, what would it be?
A hologram projector.
If there was one thing that you could do, that no one could say you couldn't do, even if it was really dangerous, what would it be?
Going down a very fast slide into a swimming pool.
What would you do if you had a potion of healing and you were in a house?
I would do nothing with it. I would just wait until I died and then use it.
But you can't use it when you're dead.
Survived. Protect yourselves. I hope this ends soon. There is not much time. If you survive, get to section 14. I hope this ends soon. Mom, I...
Mitch, what do we do? And I was like,
I hate David.
Exactly, he's so dumb.
Like, no one likes David.
Guys, do we hear his first story?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Yeah. So, once there was this headmistress. This was like, I don't know, but it was quite recent. She was headmistress of this school. She was really angry, all the kids being her. And if you got on her bad side, then you could disappear basically. Because one day this guy was called into her office. And in the office, she had a cupboard. And every once in a while, you would hear rattling. And just like a sort of muffled cry for help. And one day the girl went in and she never came out. Guys, what's that? She's like,
oh, what, should we check it out?
Yeah, we should check it out.
Yeah.
I swear, I'm too pretty to die.
Thank you.
Take what's most important, take the letters.
Take only what you can carry.
Take the icons and the embroidery, take the silver.
Take the wooden crucifix and the golden replicas.
Take some bread, the vegetables from the garden, then leave.
We will never return again.
We will never see our city again.
Take the letters, all of them, every last piece of bad news.
We will never see our corner store again.
We will never drink from that dry well again.
We will never see familiar faces again.
We are refugees, we will run all night.
We will run past fields of sunflowers.
We will run from dogs,
rest with cows.
We'll scoop up water with our bare hands.
Sit waiting in camps, annoying the dragons of war.
You will not return, and friends will never come back.
There'll be no smoky kitchens, no usual jobs.
There'll be no dreamy lights in sleepy towns.
No green valleys, no suburban wastelands.
The sun will be a smudge on the window of a cheap train.
Rushing past cholera pits covered with lime.
There will be blood on your heels.
Tired guards on borderlands covered with snow.
A postman with empty bags shot down.
A priest with a hapless smile hung by his ribs.
The quiet of a cemetery, the noise of a command post, and unedited lists of the dead.
So long that there won't be time
to check them for your own name.
Okay guys, what do we have?
We're doomed!
We just need to keep trying codes.
Of course it's not 1, 2, 3, 4.
Jurassic Green.
This is safe, right?
We spared no expense.
And here is our T-Rex.
Ah! Oh!
There we go.
Thank you.